Hi, I'm Vaishnavi, currently pursuing MBA at IIM Trichy. I'm going to talk about the PLI scheme announced in the 2021 Union Budget for manufacturing sectors. The budget allocated Rs. 2 trillion over 5 years to 13 industrial sectors through a production-linked incentive, PLI, of 4-6% of production. This approach began earlier with tariff protection and incentives for cell phones, which then got extended to medical devices and bulk drugs. Now, 10 more industrial sectors have been added to this list. The government is trying to create global manufacturing hubs in these 13 sectors to attract multinationals and also major Indian companies. This idea of picking winners has actually worked well in some countries, especially China. The Nehru-Indira era aimed at self-reliance, creating national champions mostly in the public sector through strict industrial and import controls. This was a complete failure. Modi claims that the country aims not for self-sufficiency, but for global manufacturing hubs. In China, the government picks sectors which has the best potential, supports them for 5 years to achieve scale economies, and then drop the incentives once global competitiveness is established. In every listed sector, a minimum investment will be required over 5 years to qualify for a PLI of 4-6%. Now, the question is, should Indian government pick winners instead of letting market condition decide that? See, no one thought in the 1990s that software, autos, and pharma would become India's three top export sectors. Therefore, picking sectors would be an inferior strategy. Even in neighboring Asian countries, attempts at picking winners were disastrous. The industrial policy can lead to misallocation of huge capital resources. Another important concern is, will these incentives and tariff protection really end after 5 years? No. Most industries usually wanted this support from the government forever, without which they may go bankrupt, leading to mass unemployment. Other sectors are also demanding inclusion in the PLI list, which already looks too long. Now, let's look at some of the sectors included in this PLI list. India has massive solar energy plants, and this is the justification for including photovoltaic panels and batteries in the PLI list. China is today the biggest producer of these, not just through scale economies, but constant improvements through R&D. And R&D culture is vital for success, not just cash incentives. Also, India has a multitude of small farms and does not allow corporate farming. So global scale food processing will require contract farming to assure quality supplies of produce. But Modi's new law on contract farming has been opposed by our farmers. This will scare off foreign investors. Adding to that, many potential investors in the PLI list are Chinese. India's border spat has resulted in Indian economic sanctions against Chinese companies. Hundreds of Chinese apps have been banned from smartphones. Imports have been delayed, supposedly for security inspection. Clearly, further border clashes will be met with further sanctions. This will discourage investment from China, which has enough capital for several PLI sectors. Maybe a few of these PLI sectors will succeed, but most of them might be a failure. Therefore, following China is difficult and not suitable for a country like India, because India is a democracy. Thank you.